Dear students, let us deal with one English grammar item, simple item. So don't think that it is new item, new thing to you students. It is a familiar topic to you. It is a familiar topic to you. You know about it already well. You know it about it already well. That subject plus verb pattern, subject plus verb pattern, and the sentence pattern. So, dear students, we speak sentences and we read sentences. Of course, we make use of the words. When words are separated, when words are isolated, they are of no use. They are of no use. So, different times in different ways, many ways we need to combine the words. We need to combine the words. We have to join the words so as to make the words, so as to make the words into sentences. So students, we read sentences and we write sentences and we speak sentences. So the first sentence, the first basic element, first basic sentence plus verb pattern. So in the form of subject, you write noun or pronoun. In form of subject, we write noun or pronoun. You must know about noun. Noun is a meaning word, the content word, and there are lakhs of nouns. There are lakhs of words. Okay. The number is unlimited. Number is unlimited. They are open set. They are open set. Number is unlimited. Meaning words. Okay, dictionary words, content words. That's enough to know about nouns. Whereas pronoun, we use pronoun in the noun or pronoun. We use pronoun in the sentence. See, pronoun students, that only limited. Pronouns are limited. The I, we, you, he, she, it, they. Seven pronouns. I, we, you, he, she, it, they. Well, there are different forms. They have different forms. So, pronouns are limited in number. Very limited. The closed end. Closed end, limited. And they are functional words. Coming to verb, today we confine to base form of the verb. Base form of the verb with or without yes form. Today we confine to base form of the verb with or without S form. So with, sometimes we use S form, verb with S form, sometimes we have to use verb without S form, depending upon the subject, depending upon the noun we use, depending upon the pronoun we use in the sentence. So students, here, see, the basic sentence pattern I have written here, birds fly. It is a plural subject, birds fly. You can say, if it is a single bird, it is like a bird. A bird flies. If it is single, you can write a bird flies. Fire burns. Fire is a singular unit. It is a singular unit, singular noun. So fire burns. Right? The next, so plural verb is to be used. Here. Right? It is the plural noun, then singular verb is used. Whereas here, right? Whereas singular verb, singular noun is used, plural verb is to be used. So, see, the fire burns, then there is no other form. Fire burns. The moon shines. The moon shines. Right? The baby cries. You can write fire burns. Past verb. Fire? Fire burns. You can use fire burns. Whereas birds fly, you can use birds flew also. Birds flew. Birds flew. Past verb you can use. Birds flew. So fire burned, past tense also we can use. So sometimes right, but the baby cries. You see, babies cry. Babies, B-A-B-A, yes, babies cry. The singular baby na cries. Whereas babies cry. The bell rings. You can say bells. Bells ring. Bell ring. The noun is plural noun. Yes, plural noun. The singular verb is to be used. Bells ring. Bells ring. Come, the sun rises. The sun rises. Right? See, the cooks. We have plural noun today. Cooks. Cooks cook. Cooks cook. Plural noun. It rains. It rains. Right? It rains. Here, we play. You can say, he plays. He plays. He plays. Right, student? She plays. It
You can change the
subject.
He plays,
she plays,
right?
Ramu plays, Gopi plays, like that.
We play, plants grow, the plant grows. The plant grows.
So this is the basic verb, basic verb pattern students, subject plus verb form, with or without yes form,
with or without yes form. See, the birds flew,
the past tense also I wrote. So,
you are not to know the past tense of the verb, okay, in the next class. So, fire burns, red fire burns. So you can use birds fly,
right?
Can birds, in place of fly, we use birds, right?
Chirp, birds chirp,
they produce on now. Fire burns.
Fire engulfs us. Fire engulfs. Fire
engulfs. The moon shines, you can see.
The star shines. In place of
subject, you can apply another subject, right? Sometimes, see, you can write
another, apply another subject,
and also you supply another verb.
Yes?
See, the moon shines here. The star shines, you can write. The baby cries, babies
cries. Okay?
Right.
The baby laughs, you can say, the baby smiles. The baby
smiles. The baby cries. Like that. Kamala sings.
Kamala dances. Kamala sings, Kamala dances. Right? Kamala writes poetry, like that.
The he sings,
she sings, they sing, like that.
The bell rings, you can see.
Bells ring. Bells
ring. So you can change
the singular subject into plural subject. You can change the singular subject into plural subject. Similarly, you can change the plural subject into singular verb and singular verb into plural verb, plural verb into singular verb.
Right? We play.
You can write Ramu plays, Gopi plays.
So insert any subject which suits the verb,
which must be suitable to the verb.
Insert any subject. Plants grow.
Plants grow.
A plant grows.
Okay, children grow.
Children grow. You say we play,
they play, students play.
So we can say any number of patterns. The cook cooks. Right? The cooks
cook.
The cooks cook. The sun rises. Right?
See, the sun rises. Then see.
See, rise. You can rose risen.
Right? The students rise. The students rise.
Like that.
Next, the price rise. Price rise. The prices rise.
Like that you can change. See, the bell rings.
Bells ring.
Okay? Kamala sings.
You can say Gopi sings. You can change the subject. Or else you can change the verb also.
Kamala sings. Kamala dances.
Right? Kamala swims
like that.
The Gopi sings. Gopi dances.
So the baby cries.
Right? People cry. At the time of sad incidents, people cry.
The baby cries.
The boy cries.
Like that.
The moon shines. You can say the star shines. A star shines.
A star shines. Nothing can happen. A star shines. A star. For a singular
noun, for a singular noun, either A or an is to be used. For a singular noun, either A or an is to be used.
Students. Okay?
For plural nouns, it is not required. Plural nouns, it is not required for the article to be used. It is not required. But whereas for singular nouns, we must use. We must use.
So, students, you can insert any
subject,
okay, any noun or any pronoun in the form, in the place of subject. Whereas you can insert any verb.
Okay? Any verb.
In place of verb, you can use any verb.
But it must be suitable to the subject. There should be coordination. Coherent between subject and verb. There should be coherence. There should be coordination. Okay? There should be logical connection must be written. Right? And it should give meaning. The subject verb pattern should be meaningful. Students, subject verb pattern must be meaningful. The two words in the form of
in place of
subject. See, in the subject place, you can use noun or pronoun, and they should properly get connected to the verb. They should properly get converted to the verb. So that the simple sentence gives full meaning and it is clear. There should not be any ambiguity, students. So students, you guess, surmise, think a number of words which are to be used. You can think of number of nouns, number of pronouns. Okay, you can think of number of words. Okay, which are used in the form of, so which are used under the heading of subject. Then you can add. Then its corresponding verb form you add. So guess some verbs, and you can combine both subject and verb. So one is subject and one is verb. Then you can combine them and write. So in that way, students, you need to develop writing number of sentences. Just you go on adding verbs to the subjects. You can change verbs. Sometimes you can change the verbs, and sometimes you can change nouns. Nouns you can change. You retain some verbs, and you can change the verbs, retain nouns. In any manner, you go on increasing writing number of sentences, students. So far we have learned, students, the basic sentence pattern such as where. It's very easy. Just you survive and think in place of something, write any number of nouns. So many nouns are there, any number of nouns, one after another you write. Then supply without repeating a verb, without repetition of subject and without repetition of verb, you can supply any number of words. But there should be coherent logic. Coherent logic, and sentence should give complete meaning. Okay? And there should not be any ambiguity in giving the meaning. Okay? It should give complete meaning. Okay, friends? Right, see you in the next class. We shall discuss further topic. Okay? Right, see you, students.